first, have you ever had your eye on the perfect job but just didn't quite know how to go about getting it?
On today's Money Monday segment, we're getting advice on how to make yourself more marketable, whether it's for your first job or your dream job. Financial advisor Rob Wilson is here, and he says there are some things you can do yourself to make you stand out from others. Good morning.
Hey, Rob.
Hey, guys.
Good to see you.
How you doing?
Great.
Always a pleasure. So what can we do? What's number one on your list? Things to do to make yourself more marketable.
Well, here's the thing, what this is really all about. You know that unemployment is still persistently high. I mean, we're still up around 8.2%. Mm-hmm. And what that means is really for every job that's out there, there's about at least three or four people competing for that one position. In a normal economy or when things are a little bit better, there's usually maybe one or two people competing for that position. So it's very competitive out there. So if you're going to be looking for that job and you want to find ways to stand out, there are some things I think you can do outside of the office to try to give yourself an edge.
Mm-hmm. And this is great if you're jumping into the for the first time, or if you want a promotion, whatever it may be.
Yeah, either way, if you're trying to get back to work, if you've been out of work for a little while, this is your first job out of college, or if you're trying to get that promotion, I think these are all good tips.
Okay, so number one, enhance your communication skills.
Yeah, so you know that the fear of public speaking is one of the things that most Americans are deathly afraid of. They call it glossophobia, the fear of public speaking. And so
I didn't know it had a title.
It does have a title. Cool. A lot of people have this condition.
Yeah,
you can do, you've got to find ways to go out and get some practice at this. And so there's a bunch of organizations out there like Toastmasters, yep, where you can join up. You can go once a week, go to the frequent meetings, and you can get practice speaking in front of people. Because you know what? Actually, what some popular books say is that 85% of your success come from your skill in human interaction, and 15% of it is about what you know and sort of your technical skills and things like that. So you're going to need to be able to express yourself, interact with other people, and going out and getting some practice at this is a great way to do that.
And how about being able to do it in more than one language? Is that becoming more and more essential these days?
No question about that. Actually, this year, for the first time, more than 50% of the births in the United States are ethnic and racial minorities. So if you don't think that this is going to be important in the future, then you're missing out on an important thing that's going to give you an edge. So especially learning how to speak Spanish is a very good idea if your business does any sort of sales outside of the country or with Mexico or anything like that. You want to learn another language so you can learn. And this also shows that you accept other cultures, that you're accepting, you know how to communicate, and this is going to give you a big leg up on your competition.
I love that. And then I like this tip. It's a kind of leadership skills on joining a nonprofit board.
Yeah, so if you're an athlete, there are many ways to practice that. If you're a basketball player, you go out in the backyard and you shoot a bunch of free throws all day. But if you're a business person, there aren't a lot of ways to practice business and for you to hone your craft. But joining a board is one way to do this. If you're trying to get, move up to a managed position or get a management position, how do you get that experience before you have the job? Mm-hmm. There are a lot of community organizations out there that need help. They need manpower. So you can join and get a position on these boards, which is gonna enhance your leadership skills. And it's gonna show your potential employer that you have the ability to work with lots of different kinds of people, work in a team. And it also shows your commitment to the community. So you hit a lot of points on those.
Yeah.
And it's going to expose you to, who knows, maybe a potential employer down the road.
Great contact.
Without a doubt. So fantastic networking opportunity.
Yep. Okay.
All right. Master a new skill.
So I think that people tend to be drawn to folks that have some sort of unique skill. And so I think having said that and knowing that, you want to try to acquire something that's going to help make you stand out. So one of the things that you can do that is you could go out and maybe learn how to program. You know, technical skills are very important now. So if you learn how to build websites or you learn how to do photography or shoot and edit video, these are things that people want to do but don't have the time or necessarily want to go out and buy all of this equipment. So that's one skill that you can pick up. Another cool one is learn how to play an instrument. So if you go out and you learn how to play the piano, let's say, I mean, you're really going to be a hit at those office parties and networking functions when you can just go sit down and start playing a tune. Mm-hmm. And again, these things show your commitment, your long-term commitment to learning things, because it's not easy to pick up an instrument or learn programming or any of these other things. So it shows your ability to learn new things.
Dedication.
And you know what? When you're talking about those office parties and networking functions, how about learning how to dance? And, you know, a lot of these things, having these skills, right, makes you feel more comfortable and more confident in your ability. So salsa is one of the number one social dances that you can learn. There are a bunch of social salsa nights around the city. You'll get to meet a lot of people. And again, this is going to help you stand out when you go to those office
That's
functions.
That's great. Mm-hmm. All right. And we kind of alluded to networking, but this is a big one. Just get outside and network.
That's the most important thing. I mean, a lot of jobs that you really want, you're not getting them from reading the newspaper or posting your, you know, resume on a website. A lot of the best jobs are happening because of who you know and also who knows you. So you've got to get out the house. You've got to network. And sports are a great way to do this. And the number one best sport to play if you're trying to network with people is going out to play golf.
It's got to be. Got to be golf.
It is.
Yeah. There, I mean, tennis really, is another good one.
Tennis as well. And I have that on here. So those are both sort of country club sports that are going to help you get in front of people. I tell you what, I got interested in golf a number of years ago, primarily for the business reasons. I end up falling in love with the game after that. But there are a number of charity functions and corporate outings that happen every summer. And I've had the opportunity to meet people that I would never have had the opportunity to talk to had it not been for us both playing in a golf outing. And there aren't many times where you have 4 hours alone with someone where you can talk and build a relationship. And unlike other sports, you're not spending a whole lot of time hitting the ball. Most of your time is getting in the cart and driving to it
so
you can go hit it again. So you have a lot of time to talk, learn how to build a relationship. And also, you know what about golf and tennis? There are a lot of opportunities where you have to call penalties on yourself. So it shows your honesty. Uh-huh. It shows how you deal with adversity, because golf and tennis are not very easy games.
No. Yeah.
And it also shows how you deal with adversity. If you're not playing so well, do you get upset or do you, you know, roll with the punches and sort of stay in a good mindset? So I think those two things are good. And also, if you want a little more upbeat sports, you want to play basketball and those sorts of things, there's an organization here called PUMP, the Pittsburgh Urban Madden Project, which organizes a lot of sports leagues around the city. So that's a great way to meet people, potential employers, and you never know where your next job opportunity might come from.
Yeah.
Great advice.
The bottom line is get out there and have fun.
You do. It's not all about your resume. You got to get out. You got to meet people. You got to differentiate yourself.
Thank you, Rob.
Great, Rob. Thanks.
Rob Wilson, financial advisor with Blazer Capital Management, and our Money Monday guest here every other Monday.
I created this project called The Best Kept Secret because I felt like, even though I work with professional athletes and entertainers, I feel like these kids need to know the myriad options that are available to them outside of those industries.